Now, children, we are going to start the second chapter, that is chromosome. Now, what are chromosomes? Chromosomes are the condensed chromatin fibers and which can be seen during the cell division. It is a stained body which is seen during the cell division. In this chapter, we are going to study about introduction, composition, chromosome number, general structure of chromosome and types of chromosome. Fine structure of chromosome and function of chromosome. Again, I am telling you, in this chapter, we are going to study first the introduction of the chapter, then definition, composition, chromosome number, general structure of chromosome, types of chromosome, fine structure of chromosome and functions of chromosome. Now, we are going for the means body. So, colored body seen during the cell division, this is known as chromosome. What is the definition of chromosome? A chromosome is an organized structure of DNA and protein found in cell. It is a single piece of coiled DNA containing many genes, regulatory and other nucleotide sequences. Chromosome also contain DNA based protein which serve as package the DNA and control its function. It is described by Strasburger in 1875. The term chromosome, it is first used by Waldeyer in 1888. This chromosome, what does it made up of? This chromosome is made up of nucleoprotein, DNA. What is DNA? DNA is the deoxyribonucleic acid and basic protein called histones. They are also called as the vehicle of the heredity material. That means they carry the heredity characteristics from parent to offspring during cell division. Now, how many chromosome numbers are present? Now, chromosome number is constant in all the cell of an individual. It is helpful in the identification of a species. That means the chromosome number in a species is fixed. For example, human being is having 46 number of chromosome and it is fixed whether it is that human being, it is male or female or living in India, living in outside. So, they all having the 46 number of chromosome. So, chromosome number is fixed for species and it is fixed in all the cells of the body. And whether you take out cell, any part of the body, the epithelial cells are there, so many other cells are there. So, they all are having fixed number of chromosome, that is 46 number of chromosome. Blood cell, nucleus, you take it out, number is 46. Your nerve cell, if you see the number of chromosome there. Here, the sum of the species and their chromosome number, you can see. Onion is having 16 chromosome, garden pea is having 14, corn is having 20, dog is having 78. Fruit fly is having 8 chromosomes. So, like this, it is fixed in all the species number of chromosome and it is very much specific. If you know the number of chromosome, you can easily tell which species is this. Now, you can see it is the diploid. What is diploid? Diploid means there are two set of chromosome. That one set, it comes from the sperm and another set comes from the ova, that is from the gametes. So, both the sets come from two gametes. It is represented by 2N. For example, human being, it is chromosome number is 46 or 23 pair. It is diploid. The gamete having one set of chromosome, that is known as haploid, because they form during the meiosis, after the meiosis. So, this meiosis is a reduction division and here the chromosomes are reduced to half the number. So, that is the where the primary constriction is there, centromere is there, where the coiling is loosed, which is not highly having two arms, long arms and the short arms. So, this is the general structure of chromosome. Again, this can be seen during the metaphase and anaphase. Now, here this is the diagrammatic, this is the morphology of the chromosome. You can see these primary constriction is there, secondary constriction is there. And after the secondary constriction, you can see a small body is present, part of the chromosome is attached, that is known as satellite body. And end of the chromosome, it is known as telomere. Centromere. Centromere, it is a place where spindle fibers are attached during cell division. We have seen in last chapter that where the spindle fibers are attached. Yes, it on the centromere. So spindle fibers are attached on the centromere. The function of the centromere, it determines the shape of the chromosome. In next slide, you will see how it determines the shape of the chromosome. It provides attachment for the spindle fibers. It helps in the movement of chromatin or the sister chromatids or the chromosome during the cell division. You see, anaphase, the cells are the chromosomes are moving towards the pole. So it helps in the this dragging of the chromosome or the movement of chromosome towards the cell. Now, on the basis of the presence of the centromere, that there are four types of chromosomes are there: telocentric, acrocentric, submetacentric, and metacentric chromosome. Here, the position of centromere, it determines the types of the chromosome. Now you can see in this diagram, this is first is the metacentric chromosome. You see it is somewhat in middle, and both the arms are more or less equal. When during the anaphase, they form V-shaped sister chromatids or the chromosomes. So it is centrally placed. In case of the submetacentric chromosome, it is exactly not in the center, it is at one end. So one short arm is there, one long arm is present. So they form L-shaped chromosome during the anaphase. This is acrocentric chromosome. Acrocentric chromosomes are having the secondary constriction, and above what the satellite body small are seen. So this type of chromosomes are known as acrocentric chromosome. And when this is present at the terminal end of the chromosome, then it is known as telocentric chromosome. So, on the basis of the position of the centromeres, the chromosomes can be metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric, or very clearly in the second figure you can see the chromosomes are there attached. You see. Now, this clear? Chromanimeta is there. These are the fibers are there, chromatin fibers. Satellite body is there, primary constriction is there, secondary constriction is there, on matrix it is present, and telomere the center part, that one end of the chromosome. Now this you, if you see more clearly, then you can, or more you explore this, then you will find this type. You can see this type of structures are seen. This is chromosome. If coiling is loose, they become like this, and then you find the DNA molecule wrapped around the histone molecule. Now here the DNA molecules, here the DNA forms about 40%, while the histones forms about 60% of the chromatin thread. The DNA and histone form a kind of complete structure in which the DNA, you can see the DNA or the histones form small core particle. Here the stones form core particle on which the DNA is wrapped. You see purple color is purple color DNA is wrapped over the histone molecules, and they form the nucleosome, and yellow color is the histone. You can see histone and DNA molecules, so they are wrapped and they form the nucleosome. Each nucleosome has one core particle and formed of 8 histone molecules, and a 2.5 coil. You can see 2 coil rounding on the histone molecule. Red color histone molecule is there, on which the purple color 2 complete rounds are present. So this together they form the nucleosome. Thus an interface chromatin fiber has numerous nucleosomes. In chromatin fibers, in chromatin fibers, lot of nucleosomes are seen, and they look like beads. You can see the beads on a string. You can see the beads on a string. This structure is known as beads on a string. Such chromatin fibers are supercoiled to form thick metaphase chromosome. This is the metaphase chromosome. Fine. This is the, and they are made up of DNA molecules. This is the DNA molecule. When you go with this, then this is the DNA. Now children, what you are seeing in this slide, you see these are the DNA molecules.
It is a macromolecule formed of two polynucleotides, and you can see two strands are there, purple color in this. The two purple color strands are there. This is known as polynucleotide strands or chain. They are complementary and anti-parallel to each other. That means one is going upward and other one is going downward. So anti-parallel to each other. And they are spirally coiled on each other. You can see the coiling is there. And this coiling is because of the presence of double and triple bond. You can see triple bond is seen, or the double bond can be seen. And they are the, and each polynucleotide strand is composed of thousands of nucleotides. These are the nucleotides. Nucleotides are the structural unit of the DNA. You can see these are the structural unit. P stand for phosphorus. S stand for sugar molecule. Pentose sugar, 5 vertex are there. So it is a pentose sugar. And C, G, A, T, these are the nitrogenous base. C, G, A, T are the nitrogenous base. C stand for cytosine, G stands for guanine, A stands for adenosine, or P stands for thymine. So adenosine always combined with adenosine, always combined with thymine with double bond, and cytosine always combined with guanine with triple bond. So this bond is known as hydrogen bond. They join together by the hydrogen bond. They have the backbone of the phosphorus, and in middle these cytosine, guanine, adenine, thymine, these are the nucleotide, and they are joined together. And because you can see double bond also, triple bond also, you can see adenine is combined with thymine with double bond, and guanine combined with cytosine, or cytosine combined with guanine with triple bond. Three lines you are seeing, this is the triple bond, and two lines stands for double bond. Because of the presence of triple and double bond, it has the spiral structure. So now today we have end with this, and now we are going, what is the functions of the chromosome? First function, it is the in charge of all cell processes. It is the packaging material that binds DNA and protein together. Protein synthesis steps are responsibility of genes. Very important role in the development of an individual. It plays an important role in the development of an individual. They are the vehicle of heredity. Just I told you in the start of the chapter that they are the vehicle of heredity. They carry the heredity characteristic, which is the major function of the chromosome, that it carries the heredity characteristics from parent to offspring. DNA provides the genetic information for various cellular function, essential for the survival and growth development. All functions are stored in DNA. Every character of ours, our behavior, our eye color, skin color, everything, writing and all, everything is stored in this, in the form of genes. The chromosome protect the genetic material from being damaged during cell division. It is essential for the process of the cell division, are responsible for the replication. That means they make their own replicas, their own entity during the cell division. You have studied in synthesis phase, the chromosome, they become double. The chromosome material get doubled. So they have the property of doubling themselves by the process of replication or duplication. Centromeres perform an important function in the chromosome movement during the cell division. All of us know, you have already studied in previous chapter how it is very important. So now with this we come to the end of the chapter, and here you are going to do the question answers which is given on the end of the chapter.